The maritime industry runs primarily on heavy fuel oil and diesel. To meet its sustainability targets, the industry must transition to zero-emission fuels. But which one?
I think that the million-dollar question in the sector is, which is going to be the new fuel? Which fuel do I put in my vessel? I think that the simple answer is that there is probably not going to be one single solution.
As a port, we believe in a multi-fuel future, and that means that we'll see a future for quite a few different fuels. One of them is methanol, one of them is ammoniac. Maybe on the longer horizon, it will be nuclear.
We do a lot of analysis into the total cost of operation of different fuels, and we look at the fuel transition overall. And what we repeatedly have been getting for nearly 7 years now is that ammonia is the least cost from a total cost of operation perspective. Ammonia is somewhere between 30 and 50% lower cost than methanol. And in the competitive market, we think it'll be dominated by a fuel that has the environmental characteristics at the least cost.
The steep part of the transition, when many of these ships are going to need to be converted or built to operate on a new fuel, is going to be based on clean hydrogen. So whether it's methanol or ammonia, the key input is clean hydrogen.
Despite the competing options, the industry needs to take action now to spur its fuel transition.
The uncertainty associated with a new fuel leads to difficulties in the financial markets. There have been some shipping companies that have been aggressive enough in order to make a decision and explore directly with specific fuels. That is a big step forward and is a big gamble.
There have been a number of orders of zero-emission capable vessels over the last few years, but it's really not enough yet. If we're going to get to this level of 5% consumption of these new fuels by 2030, the rate of orders is going to have to accelerate significantly. And that means ship owners and charterers are going to have to start taking active decisions to order these new vessels as soon as possible.
So the industry can help reduce the cost related to the new fuels by working together in sort of coalition of the willing. So I believe that green corridors are a great way because they create economies of scale and they create a blueprint. Initiatives like Zemba send a very strong signal, in this case to container liners, for fuel demand. And that means that we get out of this chicken and egg issue that the industry seems to be in.
Cost remains a primary challenge, as zero-emission fuels are much more expensive than traditional alternatives.
No one part of the value chain can hold the costs for any long period of time. Costs are passed through to the consumer. That's a given.
To make the transition affordable, subsidies are going to be important. I think especially in the early phase of the transition, once we get to a moment where there hopefully will be a levelized playing field, perhaps through a global carbon tax or a global fuel standard. At that point, the need for subsidies is going to be smaller. But in the beginning, I think there is definitely a need to incentivize first movers.
Ultimately, the cost reduction will need to be done by scale, and that is done by regulation. And so that's a very public-private partnership conversation as opposed to something that either one party can do on their own.
The Global Maritime Forum supports shipping's fuel transition through research and analysis. Learn more on our website, globalmaritimeforum.org.